and all. And I'm Sreeta from 10th class. I would like to explain about the heart today. Heart plays a major role in the functioning of the human body, and it was explained by me that its heart is a muscle about the size of one's fist. It weighs approximately 1 pound. It is located behind the left of the breastbone. It pumps about 5 quarters, that is about 4.7 liters of blood to the body parts. Next, you can see here the structure of the heart, the external structure of the heart. It is with a full of blood vessels, and internally the heart is divided into 4 chambers. That is, upper 2 chambers are called the auricles, and the lower chambers are called the ventricles. The arteries carry the oxygenated blood to the body parts, and veins carry the deoxygenated blood to the body parts. Let us see the function of the heart. What is the main function of the heart? The function of the heart in our body, the all blood vessels collect the deoxygenated blood that formed in our body, and it supplies to the heart. And then this heart pumps this deoxygenated blood to the lungs, and this in the lungs the exchange of gases, that is CO2, is converted as O2, and it forms as oxygenated blood. This oxygenated blood is pumped into the heart, and by heart the coronary arteries pump all the body parts the oxygenated blood. Next, let us see about how the blood supplies the heart. The main blood supply to the heart is by coronary arteries. They look like as the small straws that we can see every day. That is with encircled with the coronary arteries. Let us see about coronary artery disease. What is coronary artery disease? While the pumping, the blood vessels may have affected with the fat accumulation or coagulation of the blood. This forms the coronary artery disease. The blood vessels, the place where it was narrow, and then blood circulation is not done well, finally. Then it forms to a heart attack that we can see here. Due to the agglutination of the blood in the coronary artery, the heart attack is affected. Next, we can see the blood in the coronary artery, the fat accumulation is seen here. For this, the blood flowing is slowed down. Mortality. Due to the heart attack, several thousand, it may lead to 14 lakhs people were died due to the heart attack disease in United States. We can see here, due to the agglutination of the blood and fat accumulation, several types of blockage were seen in the coronary arteries, like atherosclerosis with blood clot, atherosclerosis and spasm. We can see some facts that we cannot remember, that since 1900 there are several people were died due to the heart attack. In 1918, nearly 2600 Americans died of cardiovascular disease, each day an average of one death every 33 seconds. These are really facts that we cannot remember. Next, science. How to identify the disease? The disease that occurs in the heart. That is none. It is also called as a silent ischemia that forms in our heart, and chest pain. Due to the functioning in the form of functioning of the heart, the heart demands some oxygen to the heart for the function. But due to the accumulation, the vessels cannot pump demanded oxygen. Then it causes chest pain, and due to this, shortness of breath will occur. And also due to the agglutination, the heart attack may also occur. Next, atherosclerosis. It is a disease that formed due to the accumulation of the blood. due to the accumulation of fat in blood vessels, it forms into a disease, heart attack, or otherwise called as atherosclerosis. You can see the blockage in right coronary artery. Due to the blood pump, the fat was agglutinated and this forms to the heart attack. Next, causes. High blood cholesterol, high blood pressure, smoking, obesity, lack of physical activity may lead to the heart attack. Next, the risk factors are two types, that is controllable and uncontrollable. We can uncontrol like sex, hereditary, race and age. Due to this, we cannot control the heart attack due to the form of uncontrolled factors. And by control factors, high blood pressure, high blood cholesterol, smoking, physical activity, obesity, diabetes, stress and anger, we can control and we can prevent the cause of disease. Next, screening and diagnosis. Diagnosis is nothing but identification of the disease. We can see several types of diseases like electrocardiogram. By electrocardiogram, we can see measures electrical impulses of the heart. And stress test, it measures blood supply to heart. And coronary angiography is the main important test that shows special sites of narrowing in the coronaries where the disease was occurred, mainly seen in the coronary angioplasty test. Next, other tests include other tests like blood test, and chest x-ray, echocardiogram, ejection fraction. We can see from this test the disease occurred to the heart. Next, treatment. Many people are able to manage coronary artery disease with lifestyle changes and medications. Other people with severe coronary artery disease may need angioplasty or surgery. Due to the coronary arteries was blocked in the heart and it was narrowed artery due to the flowing is narrow and it caused the disease. This is the several types of surgeries that that can be medicated in the heart blood vessel, that is rotational balloon and also stent. I want to explain about stenting. Stenting is nothing but the treatment that given to the heart attack people, that inducing some stent material to the blood vessel where the agglutination is formed. Next, angioplasty. Angioplasty is nothing but a balloon-like structure is injected into the blood vessel where the fat accumulation is done, and then at the place of the fat agglutination, the balloon was burst and it remains like this, and the coronary artery was freed and it can go and the blood circulation is freed off. Next, bypass surgery. It is the common surgery that happened to the all others. That is, the healthy blood vessel in the body like thigh bone etc. were taken and it is induced in the site of which the blood vessel was affected, and then it is called as bypass surgery. Next, prevention. What we want to take to prevent the heart attack diseases, like get regular medical checkups, control your blood pressure, check your cholesterol, don't smoke, exercise regularly, maintain a healthy weight, eat a heart healthy diet, manage stress. By this we can prevent the diseases like heart attacks that generally happen in our daily life.
Wonderful.